Back with Mitt Romney. One more clip from President Obama's comments about the new health care reform law, and then we'll discuss some other things. This one takes on the issue of money. Watch.
This legislation will also lower costs for families and for businesses and for the federal government, reducing our deficit by over $1 trillion in the next two decades. It is paid for, it is fiscally responsible, and it will help lift a decades-long drag on our economy. That's part of what all of you together worked on and made happen.
Comment?
Simply unbelievable. I don't think anyone believes that you can give health insurance to everybody in the country, 30 million people that weren't insured. You can give them all health insurance, and it's not going to cost anything. As a matter of fact, we're going to make money. The only way that works is if he taxes the American people and the American healthcare system a lot. And, of course, if he taxes the system a lot, those costs get passed on to everybody who uses this system or who has insurance. So it's obviously a very expensive plan. It's going to be a backbreaker on the U.S. economy.
We have a question submitted to Larry King Live Facebook page. Please ask Mr. Romney if he thinks the lawsuit filed by 13, say, I think it's 14 now, challenging the constitutionality of this new law has any chance.
I do think it has merit, and we'll see exactly how the framers of that particular suit bring their action. But I think in this case, you go to the 10th Amendment to the Constitution, in which it says that power is not expressly given to the federal government or reserved to the states, and this is a violation of that, in that the federal government is taking over something which has classically been the responsibility of states, and something we, as an example, were able to deal with in our state.
Okay, let's touch some other bases. John McCain, who you're supporting in his primary battle with a former talk show host who's far right than him.
I got to keep guys like you from getting into politics, Larry.
Well, I'm just asking. Okay, Rush Limbaugh said your support of McCain over Hayworth is tone deaf and warns that you're risking your entire political career. I bet you're quaking in your nerves. Anyway, here's what McCain said. This is what he said. There will be no cooperation for the rest of the year. They have poisoned the well in what they've done and how they've done it. Why would he say no cooperation? What if President Obama proposed a bill he liked next week? He would not cooperate.
Well, clearly, if the things that we like, then
but why make that kind of statement?
I'm not going to speak for Senator McCain, but clearly those people who are watching what's happening in Washington recognize that the reason that I would support Senator McCain is not just because he's a national hero and someone who people around the country feel is a spokesman for our party, a leader of our party, but he's also a lion in the Senate. He's one of those guys that's able to move bodies and make things happen.
He doesn't want to cooperate the rest of the year on anything.
By the way, when the president executes the nuclear option and says we're going to change the way democracy has been run over the past decades, we're going to say that no longer do major pieces of legislation require the support of both parties, including the minority party. Instead, we're going to say a 51-vote majority makes all the decisions. That's such a dramatic departure. Actually, it's not basic in the democracy of the United States government, where we have checks and balances, and where we do have a filibuster, where there is a requirement. As the president said, he said, "Look, I'm not going to get health during his campaign. I'm not going to get health care reform without having it bipartisan, being able to get people across the aisle to work with me."
He chose
not to endorse, for instance, the plans put forward by Senator Wyden and Senator Bennett, a bipartisan plan, Republicans, Democrats. He said, no, I'm doing it my own way.
Are you saying you endorse what McCain said?
I don't have a comment on what he said. I haven't seen it specifically, but I can certainly understand. I can certainly understand why Republican senators in Washington are going to say that this president has so violated the operating trust that goes between these parties and the way the Senate works that there are, of course, going to be consequences of that.
Any comment on what Limbaugh said, that you're risking your political career?
I risk my career all the time. This book of mine, I lay out answers to issues that people call the third rail of American politics. I talk about Social Security and Medicare, Medicaid, dramatic changes in education. There are a lot of people who say you can't talk about those things in this country and have any political future. If that's the truth, so be it. These are critical times. We've got to tell people the truth.
The number one Twitter tweet we're getting is, are you going to run?
That's not a decision I have made yet. Ann and I and our boys and daughters-in-law will probably consider that after the November elections, maybe sometime into the new year.
But you're not close to it.
I'm not close to it. It's something that's open at this point.
Back with more of the author of the number one book in America, Mitt Romney, the book No Apology, Don't Go Away. We're back with Mitt Romney, his book No Apology. Let's get to some other issues. Sarah Palin. What do you think? I don't even have to say anything.
Energetic, positive force in the Republican Party, a leader in our party, and having a positive impact on bringing out a lot of folks that were in the silent majority are finding they're not silent anymore. That's a good thing.
Think it could be you against her for the party nomination?
I can't.
Could be, though, couldn't it? Well, you ran.
I can't speculate.
You've won the CPAC presidential straw poll. This year you lost it to Ron Paul. I mean, you're certainly a figure in the party.
There are a number of figures in the party, and I can't speculate as to who's going to be in. I don't even know whether I'm going to be in, so time will tell.
What do you make it a Tea Party?
I think it's a good thing. I think it's a good thing to see people becoming more involved in the political process and standing up and saying...
But they go a little far when they...
But all people go a little far. People on the left, people on the right. I make mistakes, overstate from time to time, on an issue, and people say, hey, that's a little too much, isn't it? And it's like, well, yeah, you hear people apologize from time to time. And sure, there'll be folks in the political spectrum that will say something that's over the line. But overall, the Tea Party movement is about reasonable men and women who are very concerned about the excessive growth of government, the massive spending of government, the fact that, if you will, China's given us a credit card, and we're just running up bigger and bigger bills.
Where do you think it's going, this Tea Party? They're not Republican, they say, right?
No, they're not. They're not one party or the other, although I think my party's basic core philosophy is much more attuned to them than is that of the Democratic Party. My party wants to see smaller government, lower taxes. We want to reform health care, making sure that people have insurance that's low cost, portable, and can't be taken away from them because they get sick. But we don't want to add taxes, and so we link with these guys.
It seems if a Republican agrees with them 90%, if they don't 10%, they hate them, or they take off on them.
Well,
it has to be my way or the highway.
Well, as I think we get closer to the November elections and people look across the nation and see congressmen and congresswomen and senators running for office, they're going to say, let's get behind the people who can make the changes to Obamacare that are necessary. Take out the bad parts. Keep the few good maraschino cherries, if you will, but take out the bad. I think we come together to get the job done.
Some other things. Gays in the military. Where do you stand?
Well, my view is that the don't ask, don't tell policy should be kept in place until conflict is over, at least until that time. And we're in the middle of a war. I don't think it's time to be experimenting with a new social policy. I think that would potentially be difficult for our troops. Let us consider those changes when we're at peace.
Because what would happen at war? What would happen if someone in Afghanistan said, "I'm gay"?
I think it complicates the fulfillment of our mission in the various theaters to a change of policy of that nature in the middle of wartime, and that's something that I think can wait until after war is complete.
Are you surprised that Chairman Joint Chiefs disagrees with you?
People can have different views on issues. I'm not terribly surprised. I just have had that view for some time, and I'm sticking with it.
You regard yourself as like a true conservative. Where are you politically in the labeling business?
You know, my dad used to be asked that question. I liked what he'd say. He would say, I'm as conservative as the Constitution and as progressive as Lincoln. And you can look at my positions. Many of my positions, I believe, are very conservative. All of them, frankly. I know some people say, gee, your Massachusetts health care plan isn't conservative. I say, oh, yes, it is. Because right now, in this country, people that don't have health insurance go to the hospital if they get a serious illness, and they get treated for free by government. My plan says, no, they can't do that. No more free riders. People have to take personal responsibility. I consider it a conservative plan. So what's my view? I'm a conservative through and through.
Always good seeing you, Mitt.
Thanks, Larry. Good to be with you.